What's going on, everyone? It's your community manager NAKAT over at Player First Games, and today I am here to present to you a guide on how to play Samurai Jack. Samurai Jack is the newest addition to the MultiVersus roster, and he is just as cool as he is in game as he is in show. Now, we're gonna start off with his passive abilities. Samurai Jack actually has a couple of passive abilities. One to note is that you see that meter below him. When Samurai Jack is either dealing damage or taking damage, that bar is going to fill up. What that bar does is it allows him to do empowered versions of his special attacks. These empowered versions also have the ability to stack weaken debuff on an opponent, so it has usefulness in the ability to not only make attacks quicker and stronger, but of course add that debuff to an opponent to make them even easier to deal with. That is just one example of what one move looks like when empowered versus what it looks like when it is not empowered. Another one of Samurai Jack's passives is actually strictly for teams. So in duos, if you have a partner and Samurai Jack hits an opponent with a specific move, you see that symbol that pops up above them. If your ally hits them while that mark is there, they will incur a debuff of weakened as well. And the last passive that Samurai Jack has is the ability to calm his mind. By doing so, any meter that you actually get from focus from either taking damage or hitting an opponent, you are actually able to manually convert into gray health. In order to do this, all you have to do is hold down and he will begin to meditate, giving himself gray health. Very strong, right? I think that's pretty cool. Now, let's actually go ahead and get into his grounded normals. Samurai Jack's grounded normals are very large, far-reaching moves, so we're gonna take this one to top. Forward attack on the ground is a series of swipes, but the biggest thing is how much range that the first hit of side attack actually has. As you can see, it reaches very far and is very quick, which chains into the rest of his side attack combo, which has the ability to ring out opponents if hit near the ledge. Neutral attack on the ground actually has two versions, right? So you could charge it or you don't charge it. If you don't charge it, it's just a quick stab forward that knocks away the opponent with good range too. But if you do charge and hold down the move, a beetle pops out of time rift, allowing you to slice through the opponent, which not only does a lot of damage, but has a significant amount of knockback. The next move in his grounded arsenal would be Samurai Jack's down attack. It's a strict little slash forward into the ground that pops away the enemy. This is very good for, I want to say edge guarding purposes. When your opponent is off the stage and trying to come back, you can set yourself up in a way so you're able to continue to try to hit them with this move to knock them away and even knock them at a very odd angle. This move hits below the ledge, so as long as you aim it, you will be able to attack opponents that are trying to recover from this position here. And the last grounded normal attack that Samurai Jack has is his up attack. It's two slices forward in the air that knock away the opponent. Depending on how close you are to the opponent when you hit side attack, you will be able to chain an up attack out of that as well for more damage and more stage control, knocking them away. And of course, even at earlier percents, if you use this move, you can actually air dodge into your opponent and branch into a neutral air attack if you want to have a consistent follow-up. But again, this is mostly percent based, how big a character is and how their directional influence actually matters and influences where they go. They got good directional influence, meaning they know how to control the trajectory in which they fly away, then it'll actually be really hard to connect that, but it is still an option that you can look out for because it is very good at not only applying pressure, but also, as you can see, when Shaggy dodged forward, this move is so active, it was able to hit him anyway. One last little tidbit on the upward ground attack. If you do use this move, it will immediately put you in an aerial state, meaning that you will not be able to do any grounded moves because Samurai Jack is leaping into the air. But speaking of the air, let's talk about Samurai Jack's aerial normals. So, first up, neutral air again. Samurai Jack spins toward the opponent with a multi-hit move. This move is very good, not only for approaching, but of course for branching into other moves in the air as well. It can lead to some devastating combos and situations where you're able to ring out the opponent. Just something to keep in mind, you actually can be hit out of this move because the hitbox on it is actually pretty strict and you have to kind of be on top of your opponent in order for it to land. So If you just continue to approach like this over and over, just know that you can be hit out of this with a horizontal move. So make sure you're confident when you are approaching with this move and you don't do it a little bit too obvious over and over. The next move I'd like to talk about is Samurai Jack's forward air. It's a single slice forward in the air. It has good range and minimal whiff lag, meaning that you are able to actually jump immediately after connecting this move. But if you miss it, there is some whiff lag, but it ain't too much. Sword characters traditionally are very strong in the fact that they control a lot of space while also maintaining safety, and that is represented in Samurai Jack's kit, especially with this forward air. You want to use this move not only to pressure opponents, but to go for ring outs as well if you find yourself in a situation where you can catch an opponent off the stage. You also keep in mind, if you feel like you're being pressured by an opponent, you can actually move backwards with this move, not only to threaten space in which they would try to approach you to hit you, but of course to back up and keep yourself safe as well. This move can be branched into out of other moves right there. As you saw, I did a neutral air into a forward air. So experiment with just how much you can get away with in terms of what moves will allow you to use this move right after and be safe, but of course lead to a guaranteed follow-up. The next aerial I would like to talk about is Samurai Jack's down air attack. When you use down air, it is a single slice downward that has the ability not only to hurt opponents on stage, but also, as you can see, it has a spike hitbox that sends downward, so you will be able to ring out opponents with that move off stage while they are trying to recover back to the stage. It is very good in a sense where it's so large that you have enough time to actually hit the opponent and enough range to hit the opponent, but the hitbox, of course, is strict. So if I try to ring out my opponent with a spike when they're on the wall, if I do this, the move is just going to go through the stage and not hit my opponent. This would be the accurate way to space it, that way you actually hit the opponent. You want to make sure that you have this spacing down on lock, because if you don't, you will find yourself trying to be aggressive off stage but missing the opponent every single time. So get used to being able to position yourself to use this move. Next attack I'd like to talk about in the air is up attack. Up attack is a single swipe upward. It is pretty fast and it does have some whiff lag at the end of it if you do end up missing the opponent. Now, if you do hit the opponent, you are able to branch into this move relatively easy. And as you can see, you can keep doing this over and over. And the good thing about this is let's say I'm continuing to do this, but Shaggy is spamming the dodge button in the air. So he wants to air dodge really bad because he wants to get out of this situation. I can legitimately follow those air dodges and continue to punish him over and over until I have him in a situation where he's so close to the blast zone where I'm able to just kill with this move, because even at higher percentages, as you can see, the opponent will go up higher and higher, allowing you to eventually ring them out. It's a great move for chasing as well because of how fast Samurai Jack is and how fast the move is itself. So be sure to use this to pressure your opponents and to go for steady ring outs. Now let's get down to the specials. I want to say he has a lot of specials because of the empowered versions of these moves. So just follow me on this, all right? So with Samurai Jack, the first special we will talk about is the neutral special. Samurai Jack does a counter, and as you can see, he flashes yellow with armor for a little bit. So in order to make this work, you actually have to have it so that the opponent hits you while he's flashing yellow. This is what it looks like if I don't get hit while it's flashing yellow. I just pop my opponent up a bit. But if I do get the timing and I do hit the counter while he's flashing yellow, I am able to knock the opponent away with a single swipe. As you saw what happened when I missed, I just got knocked away entirely. So timing is everything, and you want to use this timing to the best of your ability in order to counter opponents. Now it's a little bit different when we actually have the empowered version of the move. When you have the empowered version of the move, it's still the same concept. However, this time when you get the counter, you actually throw a blade beam toward the opponent to punish them as well. So it's a slice followed up with the projectile. See the difference? The next move that I'd like to talk about is Samurai Jack's side special. It is a quick slash forward, pushing the opponent away. This move is not only good as an approach tool, but it's good as a disengaging tool as well if you want to get away from your opponent. The fact that it is such a good gap closer means that it's good against characters that like to throw projectiles a lot. Now the thing is that if this was just a grounded move, it could be challenged with certain projectiles, right? But because it's not, you can actually jump in the air and angle the way that you want to use this move. As you see, when I jump and hit side special, I have full control over where this move is going to go. So just keep in mind that you are able to actually do that. And if you want to angle on stage, you can do that as well. So here on the ground, I'm holding side special. I can go up, but I can't go down, right? So what I want to do in this regard is I want to jump, aim downward, and then land. As you can see, I held down the entire time while I was trying to land, and I got close to the ground, and I'm able to aim downward. Doesn't really do too much in that regard, as you saw right there, because you pretty much go in the same trajectory as if you would do this. But if I do something like this, I can actually send myself off the stage to go for snipes off stage like that, right? And then off stage, same gist. I can go down, I can go up, I can go forward. So this move is very, very good for sniping opponents that are trying to recover because of how fast it is. And if you do catch this, you will end up scoring very, very early ring outs against opponents. It's super duper strong, and I want to say really easy to pull off. All it takes is some timing and aim, and you will actually find yourself scoring those ring outs that are going to get you those W's, not only in our casual queues, but in our official ranked mode. The empowered version of this move is stronger and applies weaken. It's a series of a bunch of slashes that do even more damage, have even more range, and even more knockback. You want to use this move very wisely, right? Because when you're fighting opponents, they're probably going to be really looking out for this so they could try to jump over it or dodge it. The thing is because it has so many hits, depending on how they dodge, they will still get hit by it. So all it is timing, and of course you will get the reward for landing this move with that stack of weakened debuff. Next attack that I would like to talk about is Samurai Jack's down special. Grounded down special is a series of slashes where your opponent needs to be close to you, but you are able to knock your opponent out and off of the stage. And as you can see, it has really good knockback at higher damages, allowing for ring outs. So I like to use this move in situations where my opponent is steadily trying to come up off of the ledge, and I use this to pressure them just because of how many slices actually are a part of this attack and the range of the attack itself. You can use this when you read opponents trying to dodge into you for a quick punish. I like this move a lot. I like the way it looks, especially because it's super cool, but it does have its usages, right? Because remember, side special goes far, but it's just one slice. Meanwhile, this one doesn't go far, but up close, it's a series of slices that also do more knockback in some cases. Now, the empowered version of this move is really cool because in a sense, it pretty much covers the same, I want to say, basis of what it did originally, but adds even more damage and slices to the move while also applying all of that weakened stack debuff. And then the last special on the ground I'd like to talk about is Samurai Jack's up special. This move, like the down special, also can be charged. So watch this. It's just a swift kick upward, right? But the beauty of this move is its ability to chase, and not only chase, but ring out opponents due to its power. It's a move that you want to use with your other aerials in order to chain them together to take opponents to the top. It sets up for a good amount of damage, and then the empowered version is just an even stronger version of this move as well. As you can see, I just used it. It looks about the same, but I then lose my charge, and of course, it also gives that stack of weakened debuff. Some of Samurai Jack's aerial specials look about the same or function the same as his grounded variants, but there are some that actually are a bit different, so let's get into it. The first one I like to talk about is his aerial neutral special. In the air, you're able to do a command grab that throws the opponent, and you actually have the ability to control which trajectory they go in by holding either this way or this way. So even when I'm throwing out the move, I can actually turn it around even if I'm facing the opposite direction. This move is very strong, it's very fast, and it has a lot of range, and it's very good at catching opponents that love to spam the air dodge button when they are trying to get back onto the stage. All you have to do is wait it out, grab them, and throw them towards the blast zone. The empowered version of this move is just a stronger version of this move in terms of how much knockback it does when you actually grab him. The next aerial special I like to talk about is aerial side special, which functions the same exact way as the grounded side special that I showed before, both empowered and normal. Up next, I'd like to talk about aerial down special. Now this one's a bit different. Samurai Jack approaches the enemy by slicing downward toward them. As you can see, this move has a good amount of knockback and covers a swift, large amount of range, allowing it to be a very threatening tool for players that are trying to get back to the stage. Now, let's talk about the empowered version of this move. You want to use that move as an approach option, but you also want to use that move to edgeguard as well. Something cool about this move in its empowered state is just the little added bonus that it gets on top of the weakened debuff. You actually send out a blade beam toward the opponent when using that move as well. So this is a move that you definitely don't want to shy away from using. You can use it aggressively, you can use it defensively to try to cover yourself, but the empowered version has that added bonus again of that projectile. So even if you do miss this, you might actually still end up covering yourself because the projectile will hit the opponent. And the last aerial special that I'd like to talk about is aerial up special, which is essentially the same thing as the grounded variant, where you thrust your kick upward to ring out the opponent. It's very strong. In the air, it cannot be charged versus on the ground how it can be charged. So keep that in mind for timing and mixing up your opponent on their defense. The empowered version is the same as shown before as the ground version. So Samurai Jack is pretty straightforward in all regards, right? He might have the ability to have all these empowered moves, but ultimately he's not too complex of a character, and I think he's very easy, especially for newcomers coming to MultiVersus. But let's talk about something else that makes this character special. Let's talk about his perks. The first perk I'd like to talk about is Shadow Step. Samurai Jack's counter functions a little differently with this perk. When the armored part of this counter is hit, Samurai Jack actually teleports toward the opponent to punish, resulting in a swipe backward past the opponent. However, let's see what it looks like when we actually have full meter and the move is going to be empowered. It won't throw out a projectile like the other one, but it will do something much different. Samurai Jack will do a series of two teleport slashes that not only do much more knockback, but also will pretty much gap close against opponents. So this is a very, very good move when you super duper need to get in, but of course it will rely on your timing. The next perk that I'd like to talk about is Reverse Flurry. It's very important that we have focus for this because this is going to be pivotal in how it influences one move, Samurai Jack's down special. The more focus you have, the more slashes you're going to be able to get in with this move. Remember, down special has a set amount of slashes that happen when using it. But if you have focus and this perk on, watch what happens when you hold down special. Even more slashes come out from this move, and as you can see, that did 3 stacks of weakened debuff, which is huge. So you want to use that move by holding down special this time, dependent on how much focus meter you actually have filled up. Again, the more you have filled up, the more extra slashes you're going to get in, and the more damage and knockback it is going to cause. The last perk I'd like to talk about is called Mindful Flow. The way this move works is essentially, when you're rung out, Jack's focus meter increases instead of resets. So for those of y'all that like to hold on to as much meter as possible, this is really good for trying to retain that resource even after you are unfortunately rung out. And that's going to be it for all of Samurai Jack's perks. Now I'm going to play a full match for y'all so you can actually see the character in action, and I will be narrating as it's happening to give y'all an idea of what's going through my mind while playing this character versus my opponent. Hope you enjoy. All right, jumping right into the match. Gonna have my Samurai Jack versus Shaggy. And so right now I want to use my range to my best of my ability as much as possible because I do not want to get hit by Shaggy's devastating combos. As you can see, took quick damage there, and I want to be careful because I can pretty much get rung out really fast by this character, especially when they're in their own form of rage. Shaggy's rage works different than Samurai Jack's in a way where it's just raw kill power versus mine, where not only does I have kill power, but I also have that beautiful ability to stack weakened debuff. So right now, Shaggy is playing evasive because I have my empowered side special. go ahead and punish that miss size special from Shaggy and then that missed Sare from Shaggy as well. Shaggy's trying to recover, but I cover the perfect angle with my downward aerial spike to send them packing immediately. And now I want to get out of this situation right now, but I am unable to, and Shaggy's able to score the ring out for me, putting myself there. And that was really good on his part, to be honest. I should have been very, very careful there. All right, now got hit by the side special. I wanted to try to avoid that by side stepping away from it, but I missed. And the charge neutral attack actually catches me straight at the ledge. And so this is not looking good at the moment for me. Let's see if I can bring it back. Gonna try to snipe with the side special. Gonna try to snipe with it again. I missed that time. And this isn't, in my opinion, impossible to come back from, right? I hit that dash attack. That was good timing from the Shaggy player. I'm going to try to use that to be aggressive on the ledge, but I miss. But it's okay because it made them come back up. That's gonna be a punish. Nice dodge forward. Get the Sare, no ring out. Side special to try to come back. I'm gonna try to punish this attempt real quick. Side special to punish that miss Sare. And so right now I'm just resetting them back onto the ledge. And as you saw, he tried to come up even a little bit and I was able to get the ring out immediately with that down air. Down air is really large, so it's very good for trying to cover those angles. So right now, this was not looking like a good situation, and that side special into the charge neutral attack is gonna benefit me, and I don't want to let that charge happen, so I'm gonna up my aggression there to stop it. And so right now, as you can see, I'm just using my range to cover myself and keep myself safe. The Shaggy has shown that they're more than willing to be aggressive, and so I want to try to slow them down as much as I can. Gonna do my dash attack. This is a good situation to use my side special to cover that wall, and I'm actually able to catch the Shaggy player and take the W. So that's kind of what Jack looks like in an actual match, and I hope that was not only helpful, but entertaining. I hope this guide was super useful for you. I had a great time doing it. Samurai Jack is a very awesome, iconic character in cartoon history, and I hope those who don't really know him get more familiar with him and go back and watch the show, because it's such an awesome show and I think everybody should see it. This is your community manager over at Player First Games NAKAT. Please let me know in the comment section below what you think of Samurai Jack, and if you have any questions regarding this character, please drop them down in the comment section. I greatly appreciate it. Take it easy. Thank you so much for watching.